So I was actually born in Amsterdam, the Netherlands, and when I was 5, we moved to Pakistan, and I lived in Pakistan until I did my 9th grade, but in between every summer, we would just travel around to see more places. I originally did not know that I was gonna move to America until January of my senior year in high school back in the Netherlands, and my brother went to Temple. So, and my family was already living in Philadelphia, so my goal was to live closer to them. And the one school that really stuck out was Temple because they had a new bioengineering program and you could mix courses. You could do tissue engineering, neural engineering, and pre-med all together as one degree, and that's what I wanted. I didn't want to stick to one thing, so I did all three, yeah. When I first came here, I couldn't find any Dutch people. But I found Pakistani people and I wanted to keep that intact. I wanted to find people that were also Pakistani, like myself. And I decided to start a Pakistani Students Association. It's a cultural organization where Pakistani students and non-Pakistani students come together to like celebrate South Asian events. We also talk about like politics sometimes. We have political leaders come to visit Temple. I met the former president of Pakistan through Temple, and that he was a president while I lived in Pakistan, so it was like a huge thing for me. I'm currently working for Melzi Corporation, which is a startup medical device company that started off at the med school. Oftentimes a doctor or a surgeon, while they're performing surgery, they lose needles while cutting them. So they're trying to make this needle detector that can instantly find a needle. We're almost done with the prototyping. We're still enhancing the prototype, and then they're trying to get FDA approved. My senior design project, we're making a device that can detect proteins in urine. Urine testing currently is very invasive, as you might know. You have to put in a urinary catheter. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to incorporate a device that goes with the urinary catheter so that we can take some of that sample of urine and then detect from time to time, and also be able to do it in a very short amount of time, so not have to send it out to labs to get the results. I was chosen to be the commencement speaker for the College of Engineering. I feel like that is the one thing I can do to tell people how amazing it has been these 4 years. Engineering itself is such a hard thing to accomplish. Like, to become an engineer, it's a lot of work and a lot of energy goes into it. And being able to talk to those students that went through it with me, that's just an amazing feeling. So my plans after graduation first is to apply to grad schools, and it would probably be a medical and device innovation master's program, or I would go for a PhD in bioengineering. Go big or go home. Seriously, always look at the bigger picture as well, and always try to dream as big as you can. There shouldn't be a limiting factor. You should just forget about the limiting factor and go as big as you can.